Take a look right now. Notice the difference from just yesterday, how much the system is strengthened. You're seeing it more concentric or more circular in fashion. What are the winds right now? Steady at about 60 miles per hour. Yesterday, pretty stationary, still very slow moving right now, moving to the north at only about 6 miles per hour. Here's the problem. We know the storm is likely to intensify even further now off of the coast of the Carolinas. We're looking for this to form into that Category 1 hurricane. There is a threat for landfall. The closest is likely to get again Thursday night in through Friday morning, just off the coast of, looks like, around Nag's Head or the Outer Banks of the Carolinas, and then quickly kind of catches up with the jet stream, moves very quickly, staying south of the coastline. But you're still going to feel the effects thanks to a cold front that's out there. So you'll see that enhanced rainfall, and then it'll dissipate as it enters colder water and clears out of here by Saturday.
You nailed it. This is one of those eerie days where I think about years ago, before technology, people here in residence would have no clue a storm was brewing. I mean, the seas generally calm, maybe a couple clouds in the sky, but we do have technology, and we know Arthur is now a Category 1 hurricane, 113 miles off the coast of Charleston, South Carolina.
Give us a sense of how things look right now.
You know, here's the thing. This latest update continues to tell us this system is more powerful than we even predicted earlier. Right now, we've seen it pick up strength, currently seeing those steady winds at 90 miles per hour. It is now forecasted to be a Category 2. Let me say that again, a Category 2 hurricane overnight tonight, making a direct landfall here in the Outer Banks. That will be between this evening and the early hours of tomorrow morning. Again, what we're going to be dealing with are these strong winds coming in now from that westerly direction. The biggest threat right now is the storm surge. Remember, the sound is off of the west. All that water got pushed away on the front side of the system. So we have this huge drop here. You can actually see all the beach erosion. Look at that. You can actually see how far that is. That's the concern here, as now we talk about those winds switching directions. Power still a concern. Storm surge still going to be a concern here. Many people, about 17,000 people already from the northern portions of South Carolina and North Carolina, out of power. We still have that threat of these winds continue to rip out here. That'll remain a concern for us. About 6 inches to knock you off of your feet. That's water alone. And of course, we continue to have these strong winds out here that out of nowhere, it seems like they're calm, and then they just really gust up on you again. It's almost like you have to fight it out here.
Indra, what's the latest?
Okay, we're at that point in time now, right as I say this, of course, that these huge gusts still continue to come in right now. The latest report still giving us gusts about a good 40 miles per hour out here, really kind of just blowing all of the sand in your face. But the good news is this system, Arthur, actually continues to make its way offshore. It's headed out of the area.
Let's begin with Indra.
You know, Anna, we just got breaking news from the latest hurricane update that now Arthur has weakened to a Category 1 hurricane, those sustained winds right now at 90 miles per hour. But that's just on the ocean side, right? We have two bodies of water when you talk about the Outer Banks here in North Carolina. On the opposite side, what we were showing you is the sound. So what you have is, once that wind switched direction as the system started to pull out of here, was that really shallow water. All of that water that got pushed to the east first, then rushed back in once the wind switched direction from the west, and because it's shallower, it comes back in even faster and higher. So that storm surge that many of us are dealing with now in the Carolinas here is about a good 3-4 feet above the ground. Put that up against you, that's where people's lives are taken. Storm surge, very dangerous, and even though it comes in very quickly, it takes a long time for it to go back out. Now remember, Arthur, this is the biggest or strongest hurricane we've seen make landfall here on the mainland of the U.S. since 2008. Your gusts, yeah, they're still out here, but only about like 30 miles per hour. You're starting to see a break in the sunshine, but with all of this comes a new danger. This is the concern. What we're worried about now, of course, is those strong rip currents. I mean, all this water yesterday that came all the way up when we had these easterly winds, that water is now making its way back out. And here's the problem. What's underneath the water has changed, right? So the way it came in can't go back out the same way. So what happens is the water looks for those passages where the sandbars are broken down, and it rushes very quickly through those panels. And that's going to be the concern. That's where those strong rip currents are coming from. And you can see easily here behind me, look at all of the beachgoers. They're thinking the sun is up. Perfect. I'm going to start my 4th of July. I'm going to go ahead and get some relief today, because temperatures are expected to be very warm out here again, and this is going to be our new threat.
For complete coverage on Arthur, stay with CNN.